thank you all for coming to this special occasion, but right now with like a little privacy.
All right, guys, so finally got a chance to see Beetlejuice 2. A little late to the party, I know, but I gotta talk about it. All right, so in good fashion, I have to go with the goods and the bads of Beetlejuice. So let's start with the goods. The goods about it is the cast. I mean, Michael Keaton steps into the role of Beetlejuice like the first one happened last year. Like, he is just... fits that character so well, and he knows it inside out, and I love how he just continued carrying on the way he knows how to do this character. It was absolutely phenomenal seeing him back as Beetlejuice. Obviously, Winona Ryder, I just love Winona Ryder. She just was so freaking awesome in this. Catherine O'Hara is absolutely a scene stealer, and Jenna Ortega just Ortega'd it up. She Wednesday'd it up in this movie. But it was really good as far as the acting. All the actors, they were all fantastic. The directing, I mean, you don't get more Tim Burton than this. I mean, Tim Burton, you know, threw pretty much, he like went into his bag on this one. I'm talking the original Beetlejuice, Frankenweenie, Corpse Bride, and throw a little Pee-wee's Big Adventure in there, because you got a lot of Tim Burton in it, and you can just tell that it was his baby, and he had a lot of passion for making this the right way, and he just did a fantastic job. So Burton, much love, you haven't lost your touch, baby. Also, the music, hey, it's always great to hear Danny Elfman's score for this movie, and you know, just the beginning of it and listening to the score was just awesome. I loved it. Also, let's throw in the some of the musical bits in there, pretty funny. You know, a lot of the 80s music is making a comeback, man. I thought that we hit a freaking pinnacle with Guardians of the Galaxy and Mario last year with No Sleep Till Brooklyn. Now we're coming out with a lot of stuff, especially from Deadpool Wolverine. And now this, I mean, we're getting a lot of 80s and 90s music coming back. So it's really good to see that it's getting some fresh ears on it. The comedy hits. I think the comedy was great in this movie. It was dramatic when it needed to be. Some of the pacing, much like the first one, was a little slow at times, but nothing major. It was still great. The afterlife scenes, the cameos, everything was freaking awesome. Monica Bellucci was great. I really wish I could have seen a little bit more of her, but it is what it is. So that is my goods. My bads on the movie is... there was some scenes that were unnecessary. There was some pacing issues here and there. And, you know, this kid, the subplot with the boyfriend, that was kind of like gave me some mad Corey Cunningham vibes from Halloween Ends. It was throwing me off because I'm walking into this movie thinking Monica Bellucci is the main villain in this. But then you throw that different subplot in, kind of throws everything off a little bit. That's where the pacing kind of stalls a little bit. But either way, it was really, really, it was good on that part. But those were some scenes that were just kind of like, the ending, it kind of felt like there were some parts where, you know, you don't know how it was going to end, or did they know how it was going to end? I was not completely satisfied with the ending. I thought the ending could have been a little bit better, but you know, it's like Elm Street 3 when the light turns on at the end. I have a feeling that those dream sequences at the end is going to open it up for Beetlejuice 3. Hopefully it doesn't take 30 some odd years for it to come out. But yeah, they better get a jump on it and make Beetlejuice 3 very quickly. But either way, I thought it was a pretty good effort as far as a sequel to the first one. There's a lot of beauty in the first one that, you know, you don't really get in this one, especially when you have this appreciation of life and the love that the Maitlands share. I think that part of it was missing from this a little bit. The mother-daughter dynamic, it didn't leave as satisfying of a taste at the end, but either way, it was still great. I thought it was a fantastic movie, fun ride. You're gonna love it. Michael Keaton is just freaking amazing, and shout out to Willem Dafoe. His whole his scenes were pretty freaking funny too. So if you have not seen Beetlejuice, go check it out. It's in theaters now. It's already grossed $250 million worldwide. Number one movie in the box office this past week, And I'm gonna have another show talking about what the original plans were for this movie, so keep an eye out for that. Either way, Beetlejuice is where it's at. Check it out.